Es todo técnica. No lo pienses pesado, no lo pienses alto, piénsalo frontal. Bien conectado al pecho. Lo importante aquí, ¿qué cosa es? Ataque y posiciones. Vamos. Avanti. Yes. Mi bemol.
The sun in the hills of Tuscany. It's really strong. Why I'm talking about the sun? Well, as I say to my students normally, the voice should be like a reflection of light. If you want to get your high notes to work, you should think the vibration from your chords as a reflection. They have to go into your mask. This is a topic that I have with many people, also a little bit discussions and so on. It's about putting the voice on the mask. The voice, some people say the voice have to be put on the mask. Other people say the voice have never to be placed on the mask. Other people say the mask doesn't exist. The mask is a reflection. The mask is a consequence. You have to think it like that. It happens by the correct position of your larynx. Actually, the sound of the mask, it reflects when you bring your voice to your chest. If you try to bring the source to the mask, you're going to rise up your larynx. You're going to bring the larynx up. What's going to happen? You will not have the space to tilt. The famous tilt. The larynx have to tilt by itself. There are a few mechanisms that will help your larynx to tilt easier. All right? But the important thing is to give the space to the larynx to do the motion. So if you bring the larynx up, of course, it can tilt also up, but then it's going to sound like Elmo from Sesame Street. I have seen tenors doing that, and they have, I don't know, the F very easy, but it's like, you know, it's like, wee, wee. That's not the idea. High notes have to be well connected to the chest. That's why when Caruso was out, or Pavarotti, it was always said, il do di petto, no? Un acuto di petto, because otherwise it's a head sound, just head. Another thing, I know I'm trying to put many things together in this little video. La voce di testa, the voice, the head voice is always present. It's two different resonances. You have head voice, you have chest voice. The vocal cords are here. So when your vocal cords create the vibration, they need to reflect into a resonance box to develop the sound, the real sound. Okay? Look at a pianoforte, look at a violin, look, think about a bell in a big campanile, in a chiesa, no? There is a source that creates a vibration, pling, and then the sound develops in the resonance box. Without resonance box, there is no real actual sound, there is just a vibration. So a motorino Vespa just passed around and it makes some noise, so it cut me, I was saying anyway. So, you have the source of the sound, the vocal cords, and you have the box that creates, makes develop the sound, okay? That's why the source have to be near to the chest. Then you can have that nice, dark, natural sound. Not dark sound, cupo. No. Always nice and open. So you give the freedom to the resonance to fly and to arrive and reflect into the mask. That's how the voice goes into the mask. Corelli's voice was always reflected into the mask. Was dark, but it was shining like the sun at the same time. Dark and squillante. I'm very lucky that in my years of career, I always have that kind of, reviews. Voce oscura, squillante, dark voice and shiny, and because it's like a special mix, no? But that is the school, that is the methodology, a stronger retinoidal that you get it with a good training. Another topic that I want to touch now, this is like a general video that I want to put out, the Melocchi method, okay? Arturo Melocchi. There's many people talking about Arturo Melocchi. Do they know really what he was teaching? That's a good question, huh? I have people who came to me to study, you know, because they wanted to retake a career. And at the end, what they wanted was to learn the real basic of Melocchi, even if they call themselves people who know about Melocchi. Now they know a little bit more, and it's good, it's a good thing, but it's not something that you learn just in a few months, you know. It's a training method. You don't sing with the Melocchi method, you use it as a training method. Okay, the same Mario Del Monaco used to say, study the Melocchi method but sing the contrary. That's a little bit extreme, okay, but it's a little bit true. Okay, you use it as a training. It's like going to the gym. You reinforce your arytenoidal muscle, and after that you have easier power to keep the larynx in position, plus all the other mechanisms that will help you to tilt the larynx, have the correct stretch, and just let the voice shine. That's how I have easy high notes, and my students too. By the way, I want to put some examples here. You want to see something funny? So most of them, when they came to me, they didn't have high notes, at exception of a few, okay? But now it's just having fun. This is fun. This is a work in progress, and you have to think, okay, for all of you, then you are asking yourself, it worked for sopranos? Yes, I have dramatic soprano, then used to be a mezzo, wanted to go into mezzo, it was difficult to have the high C, now it's like, no problem. It's good for mezzos? Yes, I have a mezzo soprano, and she goes with no problem to an E flat. You know, it's high resonances, not high position, okay? We all think, high note, somewhere high, because it's high. Another car, I cut, momento. I was saying, high resonance, high frequency, actually, not high position. What I say to my students, if you will have a tree, you know, a stupid example, but it helps not to visualize. If you have a tree here, okay, with an apple, let's say 21 centimeters from your head, okay? What will you do? It's a nice apple. How are you going to eat the apple? And some of them tell me, I will go and bite it. And I say, that's wrong. Take it, bring it to you. Don't think it high. You know, the notes are here. They are not somewhere away of your head. Everything happens here. Here happens. It's millimetrical motions and movements. I will give you an example, but the dogs will get crazy here. I better put you some examples on the lessons, okay? This was my little video here in Tuscany. I will be posting more. We are moving. It's been a very exciting time. That's why I have been so busy. Also with my students. It's just amazing how it developed when you see the first smiles, when they get... You will see here a little dance of Ricardo that got, after a year, his first E flat. But a real one, eh? Chest. Not Elmo E flat. No. This is a real one. Huh? He's very young. Yeah, big way to go, man. Many of them. I'm so glad. At the moment, no more students. Full. I'm completely full. When I'm definitely here in Tuscany, set it up already, let's say middle of May, somewhere there. Then we can talk about having new students. For now, ask me over social media, okay? God bless you all. Salute. Ciao.
Fantástico. Este es un mi bemol. Esto es un mi bemol con pecho, hombre. ¿Ah? Oh. Eso es un re bemol. Muy bien.
Moviéndome me ha ayudado mucho.
Muy bien, Ricardo. Está espectacular esto. Muy bien, muy bien. ¿Te das cuenta? Probemos la esperanza. Ok, ahora en vez de hacer la esperanza, haz la esparanza. Esparanza. Muy bien, ese si bemol tiene que ser más largo. La pero está espectacular. ¡Vamos!
¡Los
high five! ¡Para boom!